This video focuses on planning equipment and supplies for nursing care unit. First, we will see the meaning of the two terms, equipment and supplies. The term equipment means all items necessary for functioning of all services of the hospital. Equipment means all items that are required for the functioning of all services of the hospital. Supplies simply means consumable item or used up item. These are the items that are consumed or that are used up for services of the patients. Next, we will see the different types of material. There are four categories or four forms. First one, drugs and medicines. Second, supplies. Third, equipment and instruments. And fourth one, facility. Here you can see the examples of supplies in the hospital. Include gauze roll, cotton balls, stationaries, and other items that are used for the service of patients. Coming to the equipment and instruments, these are nothing but medical devices used to monitor for the patients. Next, facilities. They are non-movable items or long-term assets. It includes buildings, toilets, lifts, water tanks, pumps, wells, kitchen, cooking facilities, telephone systems, etc. Coming to various purposes of material management. What is mean by the term material management? This term denotes the processes involved in maintaining adequate supply of materials or equipments in the hospital. The various purposes are, number one, gain economy in purchasing, that is save money and time in purchasing of an equipment or a material. Second, satisfy demand during the period of replenishment. Replenishment period is nothing but the period of replacing the consumed item. So during that time, there must be adequate supply to meet the demands. Then third, maintain a stock always, that is called a reserve stock. In the hospital, an item should not go out of stock. It will affect patient service. So, always keep a reserve stock is another purpose of material management. Fourth purpose, stabilize fluctuation in consumption. It simply means that there should not be a period of overconsumption or there should not be another time period during which the consumables are used minimally. Stabilize the fluctuation or consumption. Fifth one, provide a reasonable level of client service. Maintain always a reasonable quality in client services. This is required or this is met only when there is adequate supply of equipments or other items. Next one, increase the efficiency of healthcare system. Next, development and skill of healthcare services. And finally, provide material in required quantity as and when required. These are the seven purposes of material management or equipment and supply management system. Here we will see the various principles of material management. There are four important principles. Number one, effective management and supervision, sound purchasing method, skillful negotiation, and proper inventory control. About the details of principles, we will see in the coming slides. Four basic needs of material management. They are to have adequate material on hand when needed, to pay the lowest possible price, at the same time maintaining quality and value, to minimize inventory investment, and to operate effectively. This is otherwise the purposes or importance of material management. The essential requirements of material management include 8 right. Right material, right quality, right quantity, right time, right price, right supplier, right uses, and right cost. A material management system should maintain these 8 rights to keep up the quality of the supplied material. Now we will see the process involved in material management or equipment management. You can see here seven components or seven steps in the process. First one is planning, that is planning of the budget and the material. Second, demand forecasting. Third component, procurement. Fourth one, received inspection and payment. Next, storage, followed by inventory control, and finally issues and distribution. First step or first component in material management process is planning, that is planning of the budget and planning of the material. There are some factors that are related to equipment planning. First one, number of bed in the unit. If it is an ICU, the amount of equipment or the amount of supplies is minimum compared to a 30 bed unit. Then, the types of service. Medical service items are different from surgical service unit. Then, age of the patient. The pediatric ward items are different from adult ward item. Similarly, the requirements of male ward is different from the requirements of the female ward patients. Also, according to the type of diseases, the type of equipments are different. Then, again, it varies according to the cost of the item or material. Another factor is the durability of the item. The cotton, gauze or gloves has to be ordered very frequently compared to other items like trays. Then, another factor is the period of time between ordering and the receipt of the item. Some items are received very fast and some items are received even years after ordering. Thus, these are the some factors that affect the planning. Second step in material management process is procurement phase, means placing the order to purchase. Here we have to make sure, or the purchase department will make sure, standardized models are ordered. The condition and special requirements are specified in the purchase order, and the supplier are also specified or mentioned. They are supposed to withhold the payment if these specified requirements are not met by the supplier upon receival of the equipment. The required item or equipment can be purchased at various levels. Decentralized purchase is the first one. Second, centralized purchase. Third, joint purchase. In decentralized approach, the items are purchased by a particular unit or a department. Whatever a unit requires, they can purchase it by themselves. That is called a decentralized approach. Then, the items or materials required by the whole hospital is purchased only through one centralized department. That is called a centralized department. The unit cannot purchase what they want, but only the purchase department will handle this issue. Then, a group of hospital can purchase all the item that they want. That is called a joint purchase. This is done by 3 to 4 hospitals situated in the same city, or it can be done by government hospital where the government purchase department will buy all the items necessary for government hospital, or the corporate hospital will buy the required items or equipment that has to be supplied by the hospital under the corporate sector. Thus, the acquisition of items can be, or the procurement of items can be, decentralized, centralized or joint purchase. Third component of material management process is incoming inspection. The received item is inspected for certain important factors, that is if there is any damage, or if the received item is as per the compliance with the specification mentioned in the purchase order. Then there is delivery of accessories and spare part of the equipment, and also make sure that there is operating and service manual along with the piece of item. So these are the things that has to be inspected upon incoming of the specific item. Fourth component is equipment inventory and documentation system. In this phase, the inventory entries are made in the inventory register. The details of accessories, spare parts, operating and service manual has to be entered in the register. Also, make copies of the manual for distribution to the users, while the original manuals are kept in the document library for safekeeping. This is about equipment inventory and documentation system in brief. Fifth component of material management process is called commissioning of the equipment. It is a process to ensure that all the systems and components of an equipment are designed, installed, tested, operated, and maintained according to the operational requirements of the owner. After commissioning only, the equipment will be allowed to use for patient service. The sixth step after commissioning is the monitoring of use and performance. There must be a link between user and the supplier. The monitoring department or the maintenance department of the hospital will ensure this purpose. Coming to the maintenance of the equipment, proper maintenance of the equipment is essential to obtain sustained benefit and to preserve the capital that is already invested in procuring this equipment. It has to be maintained in the working order and they have to be calibrated periodically for effectiveness and accuracy. Proper maintenance has a direct impact on the quality of patient care. Replacement of the equipment is also a part of monitoring of the use and performance of any equipment. The frequency of ordering or replacement will vary. It can be done daily, weekly, monthly, yearly, or after a long period, depending on the type of equipment or item. The system to replace an article or an equipment is almost same in a hospital. The concerned unit manager or department manager have to present the item before a person or a committee for condemnation and get the new ones issued. This is the system almost followed in every setup. Another function coming under the monitoring of use component is stock verification. It can be done on an annual basis or a periodic basis. It is done by deputy officers authorized by the hospital authority. In the stock verification, ground balance is checked with the balance in stock ledgers and entries are checked and initiated. Major losses and heavy surplus are noted and informed to the head of the institution. And the last process or function in the material management is decommissioning. It is nothing but disposing of obsolete or unwanted equipment in a safe and ecologically responsible manner. Decommissioned equipment must be deleted to keep the inventory register current. Some details about condemnation of equipment and articles. This is an important activity of decommissioning of an equipment. There is a condemnation board in every institution. It is constituted to condemn non-consumable items. It is done after careful scrutiny of the record. Then, this board will maintain proper record of all the items that are condemned and proper entries are made in the ledger book. They will condemn all articles as per the policy of the hospital. Coming to working of department related to equipment and supplies. The two departments concerned with material management are Purchase and Store Department, Equipment Maintenance and Repair Department. Each hospital has a separate store and purchase section under material management. It takes care of equipment management process. Already we have seen seven components of material management process. The first five actions are performed by this department. It includes planning, procurement, initial inspection, storage, and inventory control. Second department is maintenance and repair department. As the name indicates, each hospital has a separate department workshop for maintaining and repairing the equipment. Monitoring, replacement, condemnation, and decommissioning of the equipment are done by this department. Coming to the final part of this video is about the role of nurse manager in maintaining an adequate supply of equipment and material in the unit. We will follow a system approach to describe the role of manager. As we know already, a system approach has three components: input, process, and the output. The objective of input phase is ensure adequate supply of equipment and other materials in the nursing unit. In order to keep proper supply or free flow of equipment and supplies in the unit as per the need for patient care, we should do certain activities. Develop policy as per the ward requirement regarding supplies and equipment. Second, if there is any gap between demand and supply, it has to be communicated to the higher authority. Then, if required, conduct meeting with the superiors and subordinate. Also, for handling and taking over the supplies and equipments by the staff, the nurse manager should prepare necessary guidelines. Second component in system approach is the process. To make sure free flow of equipment and supplies in her unit, the nurse manager has to maximize proper utilization and maintenance of all equipment and supplies in her unit. Avoid overuse or underuse. Then, always maintain current inventory about the equipments and supplies. Then, send timely requisition for replacement of the item as per unit policy and hospital policy. Then, be careful to maintain buffer stock. That means a nurse manager should not allow in her unit an item to go out of stock. Always maintain a buffer stock to keep emergency or to meet emergency situation. Then she has to make sure that distribution of things for evening and night shift. The nurse manager should conduct periodic rounds to inspect misuse or underuse of equipment and supplies. Then, she should check periodically the working condition of the equipment, especially emergency equipment. She should also delegate some aspect of equipment maintenance to the staff. Make every staff accountable for the loss of an equipment or supplies. If any items are out of stock, it has to be communicated to the team. Also, condemn outdated equipments or supplies. The third role of nurse manager is in relation to output. If a nurse manager is successful in carrying out the duties in the input and process phase of systems approach, the three results that can be produced in her unit are quality patient care, adequate supply of equipment and supplies, and all the materials in her unit will be in proper working status. Here is the end of this video in relation to supply of equipment and supplies in the nursing unit. Thanks for watching.